Scripting for the Web, WS300 Platt College. Data types and strings. So we're going to start off with this discussion talking about different data types, and then we're going to focus in on strings. Here are some examples. We have my string equals hello. That's a set of characters. We have a number. You can see that that number does not have quotes. It's just the number 5. You can see right after that, my bool variable, and its value is true. Note there are no quotes around that either. We have an array, which is a list of items. We can see A is a string, 7 is a number, and a variable, my num. So it could be another number. And then we have an object. There are lots of different types of objects in JavaScript. We will get into those, but here's just one example of a new date object. The first 3 have this little asterisk next to them, and they are referred to as primitive data. What's important to note about primitive data is it is a simple piece of data. I like to think of it as flat. A string is just a string. There's no depth to it, really. It's just a very simple piece of data. A number is the same kind of thing. A Boolean being true or false, again, a very simple piece of data. Where you have arrays, arrays are a specific type of object. And then you have different objects, like we have the audio object, and we have the date object, and then we have HTML objects. HTML, well, you know, you can have one element, or you can have an element that has other elements inside of it. There's a depth and a complexity to objects. So that's why they are not considered primitive data. Primitive data is simple and straightforward. Booleans, numbers, and strings can be made an object, but you don't really want to do that. We'll talk about that in another minute. For consistency, however, JavaScript has methods that will work with all of these things as if they are objects. So even though John Doe is a primitive string, for example, and Booleans such as true and false, there are what are called methods and properties. And all of these things can be used. We'll be going over string methods very shortly, and then I think maybe you'll have a better idea of what I'm talking about. Values null and undefined are also considered primitive data. They're special data types. I'm going to just think of them as just their own little unique thing, which is why they're not really mentioned here. Dates, math, regular expressions, arrays, functions, these things are always considered objects. As I mentioned, there are other kinds of objects. HTML objects, other built-in objects, custom objects that you can create either through HTML or through a JavaScript object notation. Let's start with strings. Probably the easiest to understand. We have some examples here, some good examples, single quotes, double quotes. If you have to use multiple quotes, like in escape phrase, equals he said, backslash, quote, double quote, etc., etc., etc. Those things, that backslash is an escape character. So that basically tells the computer, hey, this is not a quote to end the string. This is a quote that I just want you to put in as a character. It's not a special instruction. Don't think it is. So my special instruction is ignore this quote as a quote. You can't mix your strings. If you start with a single quote, you have to end with a single quote. You can't have multiple single quotes. Like bad phrase number 1 basically has an extra single quote. JavaScript will think that the string ends after the letter N in don't. And same thing for bad phrase number 2. It will think that you ended the string after he said. As I mentioned earlier, JavaScript treats everything like an object, even if it isn't an object. All data types have properties and methods that are attached to them. So even though a string is primitive data, there are still methods that we can use. And they will have properties as well. JavaScript will put it into a temporary object wrapper in order to manipulate it and access those capabilities of that type of primitive data, of that data type. Really, the only property with a primitive string is length. JavaScript treats a string like an array of characters. We'll get into arrays shortly. Earlier, I mentioned that certain types of data weren't objects, but primitive data. And while this string is not an object, but because JavaScript treats everything like an object, you can also apply methods to that string. The method, of course, will depend on what type of object it is. So in this case, we would have string object. Two uppercase, for example, would not work on something that was not a string. But it works on a string because it's designed to. Please note that because we did not reassign the value of message with the assignment operator, that would be the equal sign, the original value is still available non-uppercase in the variable message. Dot syntax. Basically, JavaScript uses a dot to access a property or execute a method. So we have here a variable called message. Its value is hello world. We have another variable called upMessage, and you can see the equal sign says, hey, take the value of message and shift it to uppercase and store it in the variable upMessage. So when you call message, it's going to say hello world, and then if you call upMessage, it's going to say hello world in all caps. .length is a property. So the big thing that you can tell right now is that a method is an action, something that you can do to the object. And it usually carries what's that set of parentheses. This kind of lets you know, oh, this is a function, this is a behavior, this does something, this is kind of a verby thing. Versus like a property, it's just going to have dot and then whatever the property is. No parentheses at the end of that. It's not a function. It tells you, okay, well, this set of characters, this is how many characters are in this string. There happen to be 12 characters in this length for message. Hello world, exclamation point. So it's property of length. It's how many characters there are in the string. Think of properties as ways of describing something. A person would have a specific height, and a person might have specific hair color, and a person might have eye colors. Let's make Trish a variable. Trish is a variable. She is a person. Dot eye color green. Dot hair color returns pink, for example. Attributes and properties are ways of describing an object. As I mentioned before, you can make a string an object, but they're not recommended. It slows down execution speed. There's some nasty side effects. Whenever you instantiate something with the keyword new, you create a new object. It's already kind of inheriting the properties of string from just being what it is. No need to complicate things and make it an object. It's still gonna wrap it in a wrapper to do the methods on it. There's no advantage to making a string object. So as I mentioned, everything has methods, everything has properties, even if they're not technically objects. String properties, for example, there's a property called constructor, returns the string's constructor function, which basically tells you that this is a string. .length says how long the string is, and .prototype actually allows you to add properties and methods to an object. So if we wanted to extend the string constructor class, we could do that. I've seen it done with the date object, so that instead of days of the week being returned 0 through 6, the days of the week would be returned with Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, which makes a lot more sense. But again, that's something you don't really have to do. String methods. So there's like a bunch of methods. Some have been added lately, and some have been around since the start of JavaScript. The phrase to uppercase does not change the original value. We've talked about that a little bit ago. So our original value for phrase is still, this is a simple phrase and it's just sentence case, not uppercase. Split. See that big space between those two single quotes? That say, hey, take this phrase, split it at each of the spaces. So you'll end up getting an array that is the value of this is a simple phrase, all strings, and that's what 5 items inside the array. And then we might want to know the position of simple if we do it right now. Actually, phrase index of simple will return a value of 10. Unless we reassign the value of phrase with the assignment operator, that being the equal sign, its value will remain intact. If the search term in index of is not found, it will return a value of -1. So here we have a few other methods. I have a whole set of HTML examples that have probably every method you could ever want. These are, you know, pretty standard. Slice basically says, hey, I want to store a slice of phrase from index 6 to index 11. It would return other. Substring 0 through 11. It works very much the same. For variable segment 2, if we were to pass a different argument into substring, such as 1, 4, we would get out the value et from yet. If we were to pass the argument 4, 1, we would get the same thing because it would just swap the values.
There are lots of string methods, but we'll stop here and get into the next data type in the next video, numbers.